thinking faculty is the servant of the larger mind, which doesn't need to think. When you can really allow yourself to be afraid, and you don't resist the experience of fear, you are truly beginning to master fear. The content of conscious perception is a tiny fragment of what's going on around you. Thank you. just in the same way as you don't know how you breathe, but you do it. So the Lord God creates the universe without knowing how it's done. That is to say, knowing in terms of technical considerations.
Paradise is a garden. And all the trouble began when people substituted the heavenly city for the paradise garden.
Supposing you do earn time to spare and money to spend, what is there to buy with it? The answer is the other fake and joyless products made by other people who hate their work. playing is a real absorption in the delight of a dance, for example. You don't dance because it's good for you. You dance because you're happy.
There are no separate things. It's all a single unified process, no longer divided into the voluntary and the involuntary, the I and the you, or the I and the it. It is your body which turns the sun into light, which turns it into heat, which turns water into wet and rocks into hard. And in turn, your body is one of the pulsations of nature, along with the sun, the rocks, the water, etc. So there's a mutual arrangement. It creates you, or evokes you, or does you, whatever word you want to use, and at the same moment, you do it, and you do all of it. You may be a god, you may be an angel, a deva, from which we get our word divine as well as devil. But you're not a Buddha. You're not liberated from the wheel. How do you get off? Why, knowing that wherever you are on the wheel is it. Be there. Can you imagine a world that was solid without any space? The edges of the solid would be, of course, invisible. There would be no edges, because an edge is a point of interface between a solid and a space. You don't think about it. don't think about it. That is an absolutely morbid interest. The energy will only be manifest as light if there is some body outside the sun to reflect the light. Otherwise, the light does not in any way illumine the darkness of space. You must bring something into it. This is very awkward because we are quite sure that space isn't there.
may be that you are born again as a human being. Or you may be reborn as a fish.
Relaxed people have what in Arabic is called baraka. It means divine grace, but it also means the quality of an old frying pan that has had long years of use and is just perfect. That's baraka. Suggest me a better arrangement. It's just going to stay there. If you can see the dissolution of this world, the end of the human race, and realize that this ecological disaster is simply the periodical death of a world system, and therefore there's nothing specially tragic about it. It's the way things go, just like the death of every individual. Way to run is to dance.
What is it? That's why we sleep.
was left. Be that you are born again as a human being, or you may be reborn as a fish.
thousands of years ago. We don't know how far all this goes back. But people naturally trusted their minds to tell them what to do.
It's fun. It's beautiful. Let's do something. So you're not looking for something from it. And that's the attitude which I take to any practice which may be designated religious. Understand then why Buddha images look blissful. Because cats do this. Cats will sit for ages and watch.
So in this idea then, everybody is fundamentally the ultimate reality. Not God in a politically kingly sense, but God in the sense of being the self, the deep down basic whatever there is. And you're all that, only you're pretending you're not.
So that world, which is neither spiritual nor material, is the neglected world. Most people think of it as material, but it's very much overlooked. Symbols are substituted for it. So equally is the notion that this world that we see with our five senses is basically mental or spiritual. That also is a concept. The actual world is neither spiritual nor material.